Kelsea Brennan-Wessels, and welcome back to Earth from Space on the European Space Agency Web-TV. The Sentinel-3A satellite takes us over the Antarctic Peninsula and the adjacent Larsen ice shelf, from which a massive iceberg broke off in July. The image has been manipulated so clouds appear pink while snow and ice are blue to help us differentiate between them. The only land clearly visible is the tip of the peninsula in the upper left, while sea ice covers the Weddell Sea to the right. Captured on September 25th, the image shows the iceberg near the center. The A68 berg has been jostling back and forth against the ice shelf, but more recent satellite imagery revealed that the gap between the berg and the shelf is widening, possibly drifting out to sea. The iceberg's progress is difficult to predict. It may remain in the area for decades, but if it breaks up, parts may drift north to warmer waters. Since the ice shelf is already floating, this giant iceberg does not influence sea level. The A68 berg is about twice the size of Luxembourg, and with its calving has changed the outline of the Antarctic Peninsula forever. About 10% of the area of the Larsen Sea ice shelf has now been removed. The loss of such a large piece is of interest because ice shelves along the peninsula play an important role in buttressing glaciers that feed ice seawards, effectively slowing their flow. Previous events further north on the Larsen A and B shelves captured by ESA's ERS and Envisat satellites indicate the flow of glaciers behind can accelerate when a large portion of ice is lost, contributing to sea level rise. And that brings us to the end of this edition of Earth from Space. We will not be broadcasting next Friday, as we will be following the launch of the Sentinel-5P satellite. You can watch, too, by following the live web stream. Instead, we'll see you in 2 weeks' time. In the meantime, have a nice day.